Look.
Oh, yeah.
Bard the Bowman.
Bard the Lonely Bowman.
Everyone needs a Bowman to save them. Was it fun playing the hero?
Yeah. he wasn't a hero when I first read him on the page. He was just a lowly bargeman. I know what he was capable of and what he ends up doing in the third movie, but when I started playing him all those years ago, he was a father of three without a wife, and he had a long journey ahead of him, but it was very satisfying last night to actually see the final, the look of that rooftop sequence, which was the first thing I ever shot, wasn't it, Pete?
Brian, what a great character you have in Alfred. He really helps to set the tone, I think, as well, throughout the film in terms of...
To lower the tone, did you?
He does, yeah. Look, yeah, I wasn't going to say that, but in terms of did you really enjoy kind of, I guess, kind of bringing him to life? Did you get to play with kind of where you took him, I guess, in terms of how that character...
Yeah, I mean, it was very clear on the page. It was sort of, he jumped off the page to me from the first reading of it. But, we got to play around. I mean, it was a good opportunity for Pete to play with me and bully me a bit and throw eggs at me. So there was great fun to be had with him, because he has a sort of foolish nature. He's a sort of dark, clownish character. So I enjoyed being able to find the little bit of me that's a fool and the bit of me that is vain.
Quite a lot in there, actually.
Thank you. And the bit of me that is sort of bitter and greedy and all those things, and exaggerate it and have fun being that person for a while. So it was a great treat to be him.
Thank you.
Well, I knew what I was going up for, so there was no... missing. I knew exactly I wasn't going to be up for a hobbit or anybody else. I was up for one of the only humans. There's not many of us written in the book, so I felt quite lucky in a way, especially when I saw the amount of hours they had to spend in the makeup chair every morning. I felt just saving grace.
Yeah, not having to have the prosthetics is definitely an upside of not being a cool elf or something. But...
Would have liked a pointy hat, though. I would have liked a pointy hat.
Ryan, you auditioned for a hobbit.
I was originally cast as Drogo Baggins. That's true. I was a hobbit originally.
Actually, you also auditioned for a dwarf.
I did, yeah.
He did. He was desperate. He auditioned for
anyone he didn't audition for.
I did.
He tried to audition for an elf, too.
I did several auditions. Ian doesn't know I was Gandalf for a while.
he actually, it was wonderful. Ryan came in. We'd seen his audition on tape. He'd made us laugh so hard, and he came in and he bought us coffee, and then he said, "I'm going to test you on your Tolkien knowledge." And we were like, "What is this boy doing? He's insane!" And he gave us a test, but he was very funny. And so when Drogo.
I was Drogo originally.
Yeah, you were Drogo Baggins.
I still have my
Hits the cutting room floor, so to speak. hit the script cutting room floor, I should say. We loved him so much that we just had to keep writing for you.